what's the deal with airplane fuel? Hey guys, Julia here for D News. Seriously, have you ever wondered if you can put jet fuel in a car and make it go faster, like a rocket car? Well, the answer is yes and no, because even though at the core jet fuel and car fuel are similar, they're actually so, so different. Most cars and jets are powered through some sort of combustion. Cars have an internal combustion engine, and jets have gas turbine engines, which means they both rely on a heat source or explosion to power the engine. In most cases, this requires some sort of combustible fuel, which of course is derived from oil. But that is where the similarities stop. To understand the differences between jet fuel and car fuel, you need to understand oil, that black slick stuff that comes out of the ground. It contains aliphatic hydrocarbons. In other words, molecules of just hydrogen and carbon. But depending on how many hydrogen and carbon atoms there are, the molecules behave a little differently. When a hydrocarbon chain has only one carbon and four hydrogen, it's super light and makes methane. As more atoms are added to the chain, naturally the molecule gets heavier and alters its properties, becoming another gas. So for instance, two carbon atoms and six hydrogen atoms make ethane. Propane is C3H8 and butane is C4H10. The C7 to C11 range makes gasoline. Airplane fuel is derived from much heavier chains like kerosene in the C12 to C15 range. These two fuels actually have similar properties, but one of the key differences between gasoline and kerosene is their flash point. The main reason airplanes use kerosene is safety. Kerosene has a higher flash point than car gas, which means it takes a higher temperature to ignite kerosene. This is important when you have a lot of it and it's around a lot of people, like say a major airport. Kerosene is also easily transported and is readily available around the world. Also, kerosene can stay in liquid form longer at low temperatures, which is important when you're flying thousands of feet in the air, when temperatures can reach 34 degrees below 0 Celsius or colder. Now, there are two main types of jet fuel, depending on where you are in the world, Jet A and Jet A1. Jet A is available mostly in the US and has a freezing point of negative 40 degrees Celsius, while Jet A1 is used in the rest of the world. It has a lower freezing point of negative 47 degrees Celsius. Frozen jet fuel would just be disastrous. And to make quality jet fuel, additives are injected to help stop things like static buildup, which can create a spark, an anti-corrosive agent, a de-icing agent, and even an antimicrobial agent to stop bacteria and fungus growing and clogging the engine. Obviously, the gas you put in your car doesn't need all of this. The bottom line is car fuel and jet fuel are made differently from the start, and your car can't run on kerosene and doesn't really need to be prepared for such low temperatures. Also, jet fuel is super expensive, often over $4 a gallon. But even after all that, there is one instance jet fuel and one type of car fuel are actually kind of similar. Turns out jet fuel is a lot like diesel, so much so you can actually power a diesel-powered truck with it, although apparently you might want to add some lubricant. But if you put it in your regular car, it would be just like putting diesel in it, and it just kind of stalls out because of the way diesel engines and gasoline engines differ. Diesel engines compress the fuel at a different ratio than gasoline engines to get the fuel hot. So your car's gasoline engine just won't get the jet fuel hot enough to spark, but it could still really damage your engine. All right, guys, do you have any other questions about planes, trains, or automobiles? Let us know down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to D News. We've got new episodes every day of the week.